So my name is Harrison Cash, and we are in Building 10 of the NIH Clinical Center. Specifically, we're in the Head and Neck Surgery Branch Labs, where we conduct a lot of our basic and translational research. Our surgery branch focuses mostly on head and neck squamous cell carcinomas. Those are more typically, we think of them being associated with tobacco exposure, alcohol exposure, and again, just cancers that occur in people's mouth and in their throat. I'm from Cleveland, Ohio. I was born and raised there. My dad was always kind of just the handyman working around the house, and then he also always had kind of industrial jobs working with his hands. My mom was a nurse, and she ended up going into business actually after she finished nursing. So I guess where I started to get interested in healthcare, I guess, or the biological sciences, was actually from my mother. And so from there, I had a lot of great teachers in my high school that fostered a love for the sciences, both the physical sciences and the biological sciences. And I ended up pursuing a degree in pharmacy, an undergraduate. I realized a little bit through my undergraduate degree that I wanted to do more than just kind of count medications and help people behind a pharmacy counter, which is a lot of that work. And so I went on to pursue medicine. And along the way to that, I decided that one of the great things that would help me get ahead in my medical profession was doing research. And I'll be right back. My research right now is mostly focused at the bench side here. So I do a lot of work with cells. That includes cell culture, so making sure that the cells are growing appropriately on their dishes, and then doing different stains on them so that I can look at them under the microscope and see a bunch of different cellular changes that you normally wouldn't be able to see with your naked eye. And so doing those things, we can get a real good idea of what's actually going on within the tumor cells themselves. Academic research is definitely a collaborative process, and working at the NIH, there's not really a better environment for collaboration. This lab actually itself is an example where multiple different institutes have come together across the space to share instruments and share ideas. And so you kind of have intra-lab collaboration, and then you also have inter-lab collaboration where you work with a number of different scientists on different projects under the same heading every day. And that opportunity is just astounding because you get to learn so many things from people that have expertise in different fields in different areas. The thing that really, again, motivates me is just the fact that we might be able to cure cancer someday. It's a condition that affects so many people and changes quality of life for really just about everyone, whether you have cancer or whether you know someone that's been affected by the disease. Then you really know what kind of toll it can take on a person's life. So being here, knowing that I'm making, you know, an advancement, no matter how small at this point in time, is really what drives me. For anyone who wants to pursue a form of science or research in their careers, I think the one thing that has taken me the most time to learn has been that every day is a little bit of a challenge. So science is kind of 90% trial and error and a lot of failure, and then 10% success. And so you really have to take your small successes and really cherish them and kind of look at the overarching picture and try not to get discouraged. Every day I'm answering a question, even if something goes wrong, and contributing to the general knowledge of the problem.